folks, welcome to another edition of Play Branson, where you get to know Branson's entertainers better. Today on the show, I have REZA. He hasn't been on the show for a couple of years, so we're looking really forward to having him on the show and talking about what he's doing nowadays. I do have a few fun facts about Branson I want to share with you today. Did you know that Branson was named after the postmaster? It was Reuben Branson. And did you know before it was called Branson, it was called Lucia? Hopefully I pronounced that right. L-U-C-I-A. That was the name of Branson before it was Branson. Did you know that Branson is in the top 20 TripAdvisor destinations in the United States? And when you look at all those destinations, Branson's probably one of the smallest destinations. Most of them, the rest of them, are really big towns. So that is a big accomplishment. Hats off to all of our entertainers, people at attractions, the workers at the theaters, restaurants, for helping to make that happen, that we're in the top 20. Branson is located within a day's drive of 1/3 of America's population, according to somebody. And did you know that there are over 35,000 restaurant seats in Branson? So lots of restaurants. And in fact, talking about restaurants, here's your tip of the day. Be sure to pick this up, the flavor of Branson. It's located all over Branson in racks. You can find every restaurant in town, and there's about 20, 30 coupons in this book that can help you save money at some of Branson's best restaurants. And then we have another publication here called The Taste of Branson. You can use this to find menu highlights of area restaurants. You'll find this typically in your hotel room or at the front desk of the hotel. So ask for that as you plan your dining opportunities in Branson. I do want to say that Branson has a lot of new attractions. And so maybe you haven't been to Branson in the last year or so. But I want to tell you about a few of them really quickly. Over at Fritz's Adventure, they have 11 new high-flying zip lines, 6 suspension bridges, and 2 death-defying free falls. And so that they've added that since they've opened, just added more stuff inside. Out at Shepherd of the Hills, they have the new Copperhead Mountain Coaster. It's the newest and longest coaster with over 3,350 feet of downhill fun. Over at Branson's Wild World, they've got a new expansion going on there where they're going to add a lot more animals. We're excited about that. Beyond the Lens, a lot of people don't realize this, but they added the Fly Ride Theater and the Flip Zone bumper cars to what they were doing over there. That's a lot of fun over on 76 Country Music Boulevard. Mystic River Falls at Silver Dollar City. That's their new ride. 4.5-story waterfall finale on that ride. I haven't ridden it yet, but it looks fun. Also, Payne's Valley Golf Course, the first public Tiger Woods course. I've been told it's very hard to get into. If you want to play out there, be sure to make your reservations early. We also have the aquarium at the Boardwalk that just recently opened in Wonderworks. So lots of new attractions. Now, on the previous show, I talked about all the new shows in Branson as well. And lots of new shows in Branson. So folks, there's a lot to do here. If you haven't been, you need to come and hang tight, because we'll be back in just a minute with REZA. Folks, welcome back to Play Branson, where you get to know Branson's entertainers better. And today on the show, I have REZA. And so, first time in 2 years, so welcome back to the show.
Thank you. Pleasure.
You know, you might remember the first time you were on the show, it was actually on your bus. Do you remember
that?
Yeah. And that was a long time ago.
It was, but it doesn't seem like it.
Yeah. Time flies.
It does, yeah.
So welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
It's good to have you.
Thank you.
There's probably some people out there that maybe haven't heard of you, haven't seen you. And so I want to go back and I want to talk history, because I love your history. And so kind of tell us how you got into this business.
Yeah, well, I started coming here as a kid. So I'm originally from South Dakota. Got interested in magic when I was at a school assembly. A magician came and he ended up getting me up on stage. And so I was... involved with an illusion that I then went home and told my parents about that. And so for my birthday, they got me a magic kit. And then when I started taking it more seriously, that they knew that they should start looking for places to find mentorship for me. And it ended up being Branson. So we'd come here every year on vacation. Mm. And I got mentored by some incredible magicians, one of which is still here, Dave Hamner, who's an incredible performer. And he took me under his wing. And so this was a natural fit once I started getting to the point where I was looking for a place to perform. Branson, it was just, you know, it just seemed like a natural fit. So I love it here. And this is my seventh season now here in Branson.
Seventh season.
Yeah, crazy.
Now, in that, there were some times where you were in some other, like, shows with other magicians, correct?
When I first came to town, it was with a project called Revolutionists. Yeah. And it was seven different performers all on one stage. And there's also a reality TV show behind the project, which collectively those two things, the live show and the TV show, got me to come to Branson.
Yeah.
And that was the first time I've been here in probably 6-7 years. I had a show previous to that, but then I started touring, and in Branson wasn't a regular stop for us for a number of years, and then all of a sudden it was. And I launched off of that project to back to my own show again called Edge of Illusion at the Starlight Theater at the time. Mm-hmm. And that was successful enough to make Branson a permanent residency.
Yeah, so you base out of Branson, but you do tour and go to other places.
We still tour. We still do a number of shows on a normal year. The last year, all the tours got canceled or postponed. We were in New York, and we were scheduled in Las Vegas. We had 13 cities in China, the UK. All those things got put on the back burner. Mm. And so we ended up adding even more shows than a typical year here in Branson. And as we added to our schedule, they kept selling out. And we've added 3 or 4 times. And our schedule is full. I think we're doing 270 some shows now just in Branson because we have the availability to do that. And it's crazy. Every show, if we add it 3 weeks out, it's sold out or near sold out. So
Wow. It's
really awesome here.
So let's talk for just a minute about, like, you're coming to Branson, you're sitting in the audience. Was there a moment that you said way back when, like, I want to be up on stage doing that someday?
Yeah, I remember sitting in the seats and thinking that, and just my heart was racing, you know, watching these shows. It was so exciting. And so now it's so cool to be able to look out and see that same, you know, excitement out of a kid or a family, or just seeing the memories that families are making together of all ages, you know, the grandparents, the grandkids, you know, even just, you know, adults out for an evening, like every different type of audience, age range, language, you know, they can all relate to magic. And so it's cool. It kind of transcends all boundaries. And so to see those kids, and I know that it's going to be something that they'll remember, you know, as long as I have, it's a really powerful thing to see that whole thing now become full circle. And I'm going to be the one on stage and see that expression and that enjoyment out of that family.
Now, Branson last year opened way earlier than everybody else did as it relates to COVID. And so this was probably one of the few places people could entertain. But as an entertainer, like, when everything was shut down, like, what was going through your mind, or how were you feeling, or what were you thinking? Like, kind of give us the entertainer perspective.
You know, it was difficult. When you plan for a period of time off, you look forward to that because it's the balance that you need in your life. But when it's happened so abruptly and literally you shut down overnight, I think it's difficult on the psyche. So we went through kind of this coping process with it, where immediately it was very difficult, and we didn't know, you know, what the future would hold. And so I think we just all froze for a moment. But once we kind of started to see, you know, the timeline, the light and the tunnel, we just rechanneled that energy into designing new illusions, creating new pieces for the show, knowing that once things go back to normal, we'll then be able to do what we were doing at elevate it at a higher level. And so that creative process, I think, kind of helped cope, because we're used to that adrenaline. You know, every night we're in front of the audience and we receive that energy from them. And, you know, as entertainers, it's what fuels us to create and design and do all the difficult things that we do. So when you don't have that every night, it kind of throws you off. But then we just rechannel that into some incredible new illusions in the show. I have a 20-foot concrete drill that I drill through the center of a person and raise them up into the air. My latest illusion, which we're rehearsing still right now, but it's been in development for over a year, is passing through the spinning blades of a 747 jet engine. And so we've tried to, you know, elevate the art form and taken that time off, so to speak, and do some positive things with it.
Yeah. Well, and, you know, a lot of entertainers started doing things online and having concerts online and all that. I think that's a little hard to maybe do that for a magic, you know, your big grandiose things. Like, I just feel like it would be hard. Maybe it wouldn't. But did you do anything like that online or not?
I did some TV shows that we did online. I did the Huckabee show right away, which filmed from my living room. I started filming a show called Magic Caught on Camera on the Travel Channel, which we filmed portions of it, you know, just safely in front of a camera and did the interview kind of like we're doing now. And so, you know, those projects were fun, but ultimately, you're exactly right. You know, the type of magic that I do really needs that response in that audience.
Okay.
And so it wasn't really an option for us to pivot fully into the digital world. That's why I made the decision to just take that time to create.
Yeah. So you've been on a lot of TV shows, and you've been on Duck Dynasty, Penn & Teller, a bunch of network. Kind of talk about maybe some of the television appearances you've got to make.
Yeah, I mean, those are a couple that were really exciting. Penn & Teller Fool Us was a great project because they're really focused on making magic better. You know, some TV shows, they try and tear magic down or make it corny or cheesy in order to get ratings. And that show, it's all about making great magic, and so I'd love to be a part of that. Duck Dynasty was a great opportunity as well, and people really relate to that show here. You know, it went 11 seasons and is rerunning constantly on TV and different networks. And so even sometimes I'll be flipping through the channels and there I am. That's cool. That's good.
Yeah.
So those are always good shows.
It's always good to see yourself on TV, right? This is a good stopping point. We'll be back in just a minute with more with REZA.
I brought my friend REZA.
Double stuff. Triple stuff.
And it's an amazing trick, and you killed us. You just killed us. Beautiful.
How does it feel to be the number one selling illusionist on the entire planet right now?
The man behind the magic, REZA himself, joins us in the Great Big Studio.
How are you, man?
Hey folks, welcome back to the show. We are talking about magic today, and if someone's never seen your show, like, lay it out there. Tell us what are they going to get? What are they going to experience? What are they going to feel? What's going to happen?
It's like a rock concert meets a magic show. So we use a lot of production elements, lighting, sound, music that moves you, and it's, you know, so it's a large scale performance, but also it's got its intimate moments as well, which is kind of cool. So there's points where I'm just sitting on the front of the stage, just talking to the audience and sharing stories and inspirational moments. And I think the show, you know, runs in those waves like a roller coaster. We get the big moments and you get the moments that connect and kind of touch you almost, you know. And magic, you know, it's a conduit. It's really about connecting with people. And so that's what the show hopefully does.
Yeah. And do you think like today magic is more popular than ever? Like, what are your thoughts on that?
I think so. I think, you know, the days of like Houdini are iconic days in magic. And then from there, I think there is almost like a cliche corniness to magic where it's like rabbits out of hats. And for a while, like when I first started out, I was kind of fighting those elements that people said, oh, magic, like birthday party magic, you know. And I said, no, magic could be cool again. And so there's been some incredible performers on television that have elevated the art back to where I love to see it. And now with pop culture, it's time to progress that again, forward again. The life is changing every moment. Every year there's new ways to become quote unquote famous. TikTok is like the ultimate thing right now.
Are you on TikTok?
I'm on TikTok.
You are?
Yeah.
Okay, I am not on TikTok, although I think I have it downloaded to my phone, but I've never.
Good start, yeah.
I got to go further than that, right?
Yeah. So I think it's about adapting to pop culture and where things are headed. So yeah, I think magic definitely has a new popularity.
Yeah. I was watching America's Got Talent the other night, and several of those people that have been on there in the past and even what I saw last night were magic. Mm-hmm. And I mean, it was really theatrical and good. And so I think stuff like that kind of helps. And then people are always like, how do you do this stuff? That's the element of magic, illusion, some people call it magic, illusionist. What do you like to be called one thing over another? Do you care? Or?
No, even my biggest illusions, like where I make a helicopter appear, I call that a trick. So I don't get too caught up. They say, that's an illusion. It's a trick. It's a trick. that's how I feel about it. Magician, illusionist, it's all the same. I even prefer entertainer even to the other labels. I think that's what it's really about is entertaining the crowd. Not as much about fooling them, even though you want to fool them, certainly. I think more importantly, you want to entertain them.
Yeah. Now, when I went to your show, and I think it was sometime towards the end of last year, you actually gave people the opportunity to come backstage. Are you still doing that?
We are, yeah. So it's an opportunity for me to spend some one-on-one time with 20 select members of the audience and get them a peek into my world. So behind the curtain, they get to see illusions up close, the dressing rooms, the green room, inside the tour bus, get to ask questions. I get to teach them a few secrets of things. And so it's a cool experience to kind of go that next level into it and see what really happens behind the scenes.
Yeah, I really like that because you don't really see that. I don't know if anybody else that's doing that. I mean, maybe there is, but I don't know it. And so I think the fact that you give people that opportunity and they can decide, right, at the show that night to go backstage and do all this.
Yeah, it's basically just available at the show.
Okay.
It's not something that we publicized beforehand, but it's a unique experience, another dimension, which is kind of cool.
Now you have some other people in your show. You have the assistant or two or three. How many assistants do you have?
I have a core crew of 8 people that all have a major talent in one area, or more than one area, but it's all these puzzle pieces that come together. So I've got some incredible dancers, lighting and sound tech, stage manager, all these different abilities. And we bring them all together into one hopefully seamless production. But at some point, I have to bring the girls over here because they want to definitely be on your show.
Yes, we would like to have them on the show as well.
Yeah.
We like guys on the show, but we do like to mix it up.
Yeah.
Because there's both sides. You can't have all females, can't have all males. In fact, earlier this year, I had a whole bunch of males, and I'm like, we gotta get some females on the show, because if not, someone will probably get mad at us. But
next time, I'll bring the diversity.
So how do you... how do you determine what you're going to put in the show in the future? How does that work?
I actually change the show even just based on the audience. I do something now where I take requests from the audience. And I started doing this recently. And whatever they want to see, I find a way to bring it to life. And so I do that in the first half. And during the intermission, I figure out how I'm going to do that. And during the second half, I take requests. So I'll sometimes pivot the show based on the crowd. Sometimes I feel like their energy, they want to see something dangerous or daring, and I might put something in special just for that audience. But, overall, I listen to the audience. Even while I'm performing the illusions, the crowd is looking at the show, and to them, that's the show. And to me, the show is watching the audience, seeing what they react to, how they react to it. I mean, there's moments that we just applaud because how we're wired. Something happens, and the response is to applaud. But I love the moments where people aren't intending to react, the gasps, just the offbeat moments where they don't know how to react. And sometimes there's screams, sometimes there's cheers, and it's all that. And so I watch those moments, and whatever I feel like brings the most energy and uniqueness out of the crowd, I design a magic that goes after those specific reactions.
So tell people where you're at, when you're performing, kind of give them the rundown on that.
I'm at the Branson Famous Theater And so you turn Titanic on 165 about a mile down the road. And right now we have shows every single day.
Every single day. And so they are they all the same time or do they vary? Or
it varies between 2 o'clock or 8 o'clock. But right now it's every day. And then it goes to a 5-show-a-week schedule. And so it's always good to double check the website. But yeah, right now we're we literally have no days off.
Wow.
We love it.
See, folks, I'm always telling you our entertainers are the hardest working people in Branson. And here's just another example, like working hard. And of course, for you, summer is probably your peak season, although you're busy other times of year. But
yeah, we tour during the fall. Peak season for our show here is spring break, summer, and then the holidays. Mm-hmm. But this year in particular, we filled in the gaps in between, and we're here quite a bit.
Well, and my theory, quite honestly, is magic and illusions and all of that are really good for all ages.
Yeah.
Like you can be old and enjoy it. You can be young and enjoy it. And what I think Branson is one of those few places where grandma and grandpa, mom and dad, and the kids can all come. So you can literally have three generations in your show, and they're all going to enjoy it.
That's what I love about it.
You know.
Yeah.
So you got lighting. You've got these big video things in the background.
Yes.
And so I love your description of what you said. What a rock and roll. Say that again.
Rock concert meets a magic show.
Rock concert meets magic show. And I think that's a great description of the show. And so folks, go check out Reza over at Branson Famous Theater. He's on Highway 165. And if they want to go to your website, what's the website?
It's rezalive.com.
Rezalive.com. So go check out his website. Check him out on social media. Thanks for coming today.
Thanks for having me.
It's good to have you on the show. We'll be back in just a moment to wrap the show up.
There are so many things to do in Branson. You need help planning and booking all your fun. You need iBranson.com. You can find everything Branson has to offer, from your computer, tablet, or cell phone. You can even buy tickets online or talk to one of their friendly Branson travel specialists. There's no sales pitches, no delivery fees, no service fees, and no waiting. It's fast and easy. Find your fun at iBranson.com. Do it all online or call 877-ENTERTAIN. That's 877-368-3782. iBranson.com.
Hey folks, we're wrapping the show up today. I want to thank Reza for coming out. Be sure to go see him. He's located down on Highway 165 at Branson's Famous Theater. It's on the right-hand side, just off 76, probably about half a mile to a mile. So check out the show there. I do want to mention that Silver Dollar City's Moonlight Madness is going to be going on from July 24th to August 8th. They do have fireworks at night there. And then coming up later this summer, but you can be planning now, is Silver Dollar City Southern Gospel Picnic. And that begins in just about a month from August 27th through Labor Day. Lots of different Southern Gospel folks are going to be out there. You're going to have a great time with that. Here's the deal. If you haven't planned your summer vacation, time is running out. You need to do that. And Branson's the perfect place to come. The folks at iBranson.com can help you plan your vacation. They can help you with your hotel, your shows, your attractions. They can even get you some dining vouchers where you'll save big bucks. You can go to iBranson.com or you can call them at 877-ENTERTAIN. And let me tell you, you can get a hold of a real person here in Branson. Unlike Ticketmaster, you can't even talk to a real person anymore. They have great service, local experts. Check them out at iBranson.com. Thanks for watching, and we'll be back next week with more.